Welcome. In this one, I'm going to show you how to find the following. So I have here, the objective is to find the real part of z minus a over z plus a. Keep that in mind. So remember that z is defined as x plus yi, so x is the real part of y, the imaginary I, the imaginary unit. This is a complex number, in other words. And to find the real part of z minus a over z plus a, we can say that it's x plus yi minus a. A is just some number, for example. X plus yi plus a. And what I want to do is I want to group the x and the negative a together, and then also in the bottom the x with the positive a, because they're similar values, all real numbers basically. So it kind of ends up being x minus a plus yi over x plus a plus yi. And I deliberately did it this way, because trying to write this out in real time is not so easy. That's why I pre-typed it, just so you know. And notice that here I'm just focusing on taking x plus yi minus a and x plus yi plus a. I'm just going to write it out. And I'm going to take the real part of everything at the very end where it's relevant to do so. So what I need to do is multiply by x plus a minus yi and then x plus a minus yi, because x plus a minus yi is the complex conjugate of x plus a plus yi. Notice that the above my head is a plus and over here is a minus. So I'm taking the complex conjugate. Now let's carry out some of the multiplications. This is really just a lot of algebra and that's about it. But it's a bit intense. So I'm going to have x minus a multiplying x plus a in the top. So I'm going to have x minus a times x plus a for that reason. Then I'm going to have, just follow my head, x minus a multiplying negative yi. That's going to give me here the following. The negative here is from in front of the negative yi, and then it's x minus a times yi for that reason. Continue. I'm doing FOIL on the top, basically. This yi times x plus a. So then it's going to be plus yi times x plus a. Then it's going to be yi times negative yi, which will be negative y squared I squared. In the bottom, where you have x plus a plus yi multiplying x plus a minus yi, because those are complex conjugates, the result, I'm not going to go over that because at this level you should really know that, it's x plus a squared plus y squared. So once that is in place, we can simplify things a little bit. So I can FOIL x minus a with x plus a. When I do that, it's going to give me down below, as you can see, x squared minus a squared, because x minus a times x plus a is a difference of two squares factored. Then I'm going to distribute as follows. I'm going to distribute the negative 1 above my head over to the x and the negative a, and also distribute the yi over to the x and the a. So when I do that down below, it's going to give me negative x yi plus a yi. After that, come up here, line 5. Yi distributed to x and a will be done next. That's going to give you positive yix plus yix, yia rather, be careful. Then over here, it's going to be negative y squared times I squared. Well, I squared is negative 1. Negative 1 times that negative y squared. Down below will give you a positive y squared. Continue. So clean up what you can. That means the following. X squared and then the y squared can be placed adjacent to each other. So when I go from 6 to 7, I have x squared plus y squared for that reason. Notice also the following, that this term, negative xyi, and let's see, this one here, this positive yix, they have the same letters, right? They both have a y and a y. They both have an x, and they both have an I and an I. So it's the same term. So you can cancel that off. That goes away from the top of step number 7, essentially. Now, that part that's the negative a squared, that you can't cancel. So that's got to be copied down to this position, for example. And also observe this other piece. Ayi can be added with this other yia because it's the same two terms. So it's there two times. So for that reason, down below, it's going to give you 2 times yai over x plus a squared plus y squared. Oh boy. Okay, let's continue. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rewrite x squared plus y squared. That's just the square of the modulus of the complex number z. So up here, it looks like the following across the top, step 8, just becomes, for that reason, the modulus of z squared. That other piece minus a squared plus 2yi stays. And then the bottom, take a look. Go back down to step 7 on the bottom. I have x plus a squared plus y squared. Basically, just FOIL that out, gather like terms, the usual thing. So over here, there should be a plus a squared, okay? Right there in this position. So plus a squared above my head. Anyway, let's continue. That's the only thing. So then, what I can do is I can do x squared plus y squared. Again, I'm gathering those together because those two represent the square of the modulus of z. And then it's 2ax. That's from this middle up here. And then a squared, the one that I just added at step 8 and read, comes down here. So I had it there, I just forgot it at step 8 for some reason. Anyway, let's continue. So here, this part, x squared plus y squared, down below at step 10 can be written as the modulus of z squared. Whenever you encounter x, now remember, what is that? Go back over here. X, right here at step 2, that's the real part of the number z. So at step 10 right here, I put rez, meaning the real part of z. I'm using that to replace x. Let's continue. And then the y, a squared rather, stays, and so on. So let's continue to step 11. So what is that telling me? What it's telling me is the following, that the real part of z minus a over z plus a would be equal to the modulus of z squared minus a squared over z squared plus 2 times a times the real part of z plus a squared. Where is that coming from? So it's very clear. But back to step 10. You see 2ya has the I next to it. So what I've done is, you got to take the real part from the top, which is z squared minus a squared, because neither one of those has I. So that becomes the top at step 11, essentially, you see? And again, then you got to put it over the bottom from step 10 at step 11. So this is then the real part of z minus a over z plus a, above my head. The imaginary part, well, go back to step 10. You see, you have 2yai. So 2ya, that's the imaginary part because it's together with the I. So you take that 2ya and you place it over that whole bottom at step 10. So that means at step 12, you would say im of z minus a over z plus a. So the imaginary part of that ratio of two complex numbers, basically, is 2ya over the mag or modulus of z squared plus 2a real part of z plus a squared. And the only part that remains is this one. What is this y in this position at step 12 above my head? Well, think back. Go over here to step 2. Y is the imaginary part of the number z, which means that step 13 down below, y can be replaced with imz. In other words, the imaginary part of z. Just use that notation. And then at step 13, you have the imaginary part of z minus a over z plus a is this quantity down below. That's pretty much it. So thank you so much for watching. Please give a like and subscribe. I've tried to type everything as neatly as I know how. Again, I pre-typed it because trying to write all of this out can get really crazy in real time in a video. Please give a like and subscribe. I'll see you in another one.